Hey, Alec here, and today I'm about to share with you how to charge for websites and for web development services as a freelance web developer starting out. But before I share with you exactly how much money you should charge, there's a little story I want to share with you. When I started freelancing, I expected it was going to pay a little more than a regular job. And before I got my first client, I enrolled in a freelancing course to know how to get clients because I wasn't really comfortable with getting clients, meeting people, sending emails, all that kind of thing. And I wanted to know how to do it correctly. And during that course, when I heard the instructor say how much he believed freelancers should charge, I was just like astonished. It felt like the number was really too big to be true. And when I'm gonna tell you how much you should charge, it will look like an astronomically high number. But there's something you need to understand, okay? The amount of money per hour that you charge as a freelancer is not really comparable to how much you would charge as someone with a job. Because you need to understand the number is gonna be higher because you're also compensating for the fact that you're not paid for all the hours you work trying to find clients. You know, you're not paid for your client meetings, you're not paid for that kind of thing. And you also need to account for taxes and a lot of things. So the number per hour has to be higher. And yes, you will be making more money than the average developer who gets a job starting out, but it's not because the number seems astronomically large to you that it's actually that way, because again, you'll have taxes to pay on that and you'll have other expenses to account for. So the number that you should charge per hour for web development services is about $65 per hour. This number is based on my experience, what I've been able to charge, and other freelancers and agency owners that I know, that I've seen how much they charge, and I've made basically a rough estimate of how much you should charge based on that. This is a very average starting wage if I check with all the freelancers and agency owners that I've met. $65 an hour. If we're to make an estimate on how much you should charge for a website, the basic websites basically take around 30 to 40 hours to make, okay? So most of the websites you're gonna make starting out, if you start out with small projects, are gonna be about 30 to 40 hours, okay? That means on average, probably around 35 hours, okay? 35 hours, okay? But think about it, there's a lot of hours you're gonna be spending on that project, talking with a client, that are not going to be paid, probably an 8 hour not paid. There's also the fact that you will be trying to get other clients, and some people that you approach do not end up being your clients, and if they don't end up being your clients, they don't pay you. So you're going to be spending a lot of time also trying to get other clients that you don't get. So theoretically, to get 35 hours paid at $65 an hour, you might end up spending maybe 45 hours. It's still around maybe $40 to $45 an hour that you're gonna get, but it's not, but you know, as you can see, the $65 an hour, when you look at it through that lens of all the hours you're not getting paid, $65 an hour doesn't seem so big when you look at it through that lens. And what you need to understand is that $65 an hour is just what you're gonna get starting out. This is what you charge starting out, and very quickly you should be able to transition to $85 per hour or even $100 an hour, and after that, more in the next coming years as you get a better portfolio, better website, and people wanna work with you more. Another thing you need to understand about this is that yes, despite all the not paid hours, despite all the taxes, this is still more than what the average person with a job would make. So if we look at it, how much should you charge for a website? 35 hours at $65 an hour, that is an average of $2,275 per website. That should be your average project starting out. If you don't want to charge per hour and you want to charge per project, just charge $2,275 and that's it. Don't worry about it. And you know, depending on which website you're gonna make, obviously some clients are going to have bigger websites than others. Some of your clients are going to take more time than others. And at that point, when you're starting out, it's very hard to estimate how much time it's going to take, because you know you need to account for the fact that your clients are probably going to be asking for revisions, which, you know, it's not something that happens when you're in school. It's a bit different when you're working with a client than when you're working on a school project or something that you are 100% in charge of, because you also need to cater to their needs and their unforeseen amounts of time that you need to spend to adjust your work to make it exactly how they want. So at first, it's going to be really hard for you to estimate how many hours it's going to take. So I recommend just charging for 35 hours for your first few projects, see how it goes, see how much time it exactly takes you, and then you can change your wages for your next following clients based on how much time it takes you on average to make websites like that. Okay, so now that you know that the average cost for the base website is $2,075, for the basic site, you know, some clients are going to ask for extra features. Some clients are going to need other services from you. And the most common thing that people want to add on a website is going to be a CMS. A CMS, which is maybe WordPress, Joomla, or any other tool that's going to allow them to customize the website by themselves without knowing how to code, basically. So if you include a CMS, okay, let's say WordPress, I usually charge that at $200 flat. So if you had a CMS, we're at $2,475. And any other feature they want to add, I'd say $65 an hour, okay? Really, it's going to depend on which feature, how much you're going to charge exactly. Like, obviously, like adding a shop on their site is going to be something that takes quite a few hours. But there's a lot of things that your clients could be asking for. But what I recommend you do is try to offer these as little as possible, okay? Don't get into it at the start, okay? Yes, you could probably sell your clients extra features on their sites. It's not that hard to convince people that some features are worth doing, and it's not that hard to get them to pay you more money, but you need to be careful about doing these kind of things, because you're a freelancer, you're not an employee. If you fuck up, you're the one that takes the blame. You're the one that gets in trouble. If you're an employee and the project goes bad, your boss is gonna be mad at you, but you're not gonna lose money, okay? You're still gonna get paid. But if you're a freelancer and you fuck up, your clients are gonna start asking refunds. And all the hours, all the 35 hours you spent here, all the 10 hours you spent getting that clients that they paid you to get the website, or halfway paid you, because let's face it, normally you don't get paid 100% of the money until it's finished. You get paid maybe 25% at the start and 25% at the halfway point of the project. But all the money that they have paid you so far, if they have paid you money, if you fuck up and you don't manage to deliver the feature that you promised, you will have to refund that money, and you will have spent all that time working for nothing. And if they haven't paid you yet and you fuck up, it's very possible that they'll just decide not to pay you because you didn't fulfill your end of the contract. But listen, man, you should not get scared about this, okay? The truth is, if you just start with simple things, the basic website, and that you know you can do, okay, you shouldn't get into trouble for that because you know you can build it, okay? I'm just talking about if you, let's say I'm going to build a shopping thing on your site and you've never done it, it might be risky because it's possible you will not be able to deliver it before the end of your deadline. So it's a risk you're taking. Another thing that you will generally have to account for when you're selling websites is hosting, okay? Sometimes your clients have already bought a hosting plan with some company, and they've already purchased their domain. And if that happens, generally you can just charge 1 hour of work at $65 an hour, and you should have enough to put it on their cPanel or using FTP to get your files on their server. But if they don't have a hosting plan that they've already purchased and domain, You should charge for it. This is the easiest way to get passive income as a web developer that I know. And it's really cool because if you are the one who charged them for hosting and their domain, you can charge them again every year, year after year, and make profit off of it. Let's say you pay for hosting for a couple of dollars a month, and you, well, actually, I'm going to give you how much you should charge for hosting. For both hosting and domain, I'd say about $110 a year, okay? It's probably gonna cost you around $30, okay? So if you're selling it at $30 and you're making $110 a year, it's about $80 a year in profit, okay? This might not sound like a lot, but think about it. These people are gonna pay you again and again and again, year after year, because they wanna keep their website on the internet. And if they stop paying for hosting and domains, their website stops existing. So it is passive income. And what's really cool is that every client you get that needs hosting and domains, which let's face it, is kind of a lot of them, are going to be paying you that. Let's say you get 10 clients in a year that all need this. Now you're getting $800 a year in passive income. That's a lot of fucking money. Like, if this year you get $800 for not working, next year you get $800, and think about it, like, the year after that, if you get 10 more clients after that, the year after that, you're probably going to make $1,600, like, assuming that no clients are going to drop out, but, like, over time, this can become a very substantial source of money for your business. If after 3 years you get $800 a year worth of client to add to all your client base that pays you, that gives you an $80 a year profit, after 3 years, like, that's $2,400. You could buy a car with that amount of money. Like, and the year after that, you're still gonna make that. It's like you get a free car every fucking year. It's kind of crazy. And the funny thing is that there are ways to lower the amount it costs you to pay for your client's hosting so that you can make more than that per client. If you want to see my video on how to charge for hosting and make as much passive income as possible for your existing clients and past clients for the next couple of years, which is going to be thousands of dollars more in your pocket if you do this correctly, go check out my video. I'll put a link to it in the description and hopefully maybe up here as well. And you know, that's kind of free money. Like, if you don't do this, like, your clients are still gonna need hosting anyway. And like, it's not like you need to convince your clients to get on this train. It's just like, for them, nothing changes. The only thing that changes is how much you pay. And if you pay less per clients, that's just free money for you. So go check that video. It's gonna give you hundreds of more dollars in your pockets if you do it correctly in the next couple of years. Subscribe, and I'll see you soon. Take care.